Great, we've learned so much about efficiency. When you look at two pieces of code, you can maybe tell which one is going to be faster and which one is going to be slower. But how do we say definitively which one is faster and which one is slower? And how do we communicate that with our coworkers and the people around us? We can describe efficiency of code with something called Big O notation. The name is odd if you're hearing it for the first time, but it turns out to be a very straightforward name. Every time you use this notation, you literally write a capital letter O, parentheses, and some algebraic expression inside the parentheses. The algebraic expression is always going to be a mathematical function of the variable n, such as some of these examples. As you can see, these all contain algebraic expressions with the letter n. The only exception is this guy right here. Yes, the number 1 still counts. It's just another way to write 0n plus 1, so this is a value we can still use. So what does the algebraic expression mean in this case? Well, n represents the length of an input to your function. Let's say you received a secret coded message from one of your friends, and a cipher that tells you which letter maps to what. You want to automatically decode the coded messages with the cipher your friend gave you, so you write some pseudocode to figure out how you can do that. You take a string input, you iterate through it and change each letter based on the cipher, and then you output a new message. This pseudocode shows you what it might actually look like. Okay, so to get a sense of the time efficiency, we're just going to count up the number of lines. Creating an output string and returning an output string each only need to happen once every time the function is run. To represent that, we can go ahead and add a 2 to our efficiency. Now, both lines inside the for loop have to get run for every letter in the input. For those, we can add a 2n, since 2 is the number of letters in our input string, and we have 2 lines that need to get run for each one. Hopefully, the way we count up lines and turn it into something in Big O notation is starting to make sense to you. Let's take a look at some examples. If our input string had 10 letters, the calculation would look something like this, and we would end up with the value 22. To get the actual efficiency, you can multiply 22 times the amount of time it takes for your computer to run one line of code. If the input string was 1 million, you would have to multiply 2 million times the amount of time it takes for your computer to do a computation. There you go, looks like you've got the basics down.